Shalom. I want to start off by giving all glory and honor to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakakwadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone who rule well, and peace and salutations to the hopeful elect who are continuing to fight and teach this thing of ours in truth and sincerity here in these last days in Babylon the Great. I'm the brother Manatazak with GMS Ancient of Days in Los Angeles, currently teaching with the Small Sanctuary in Inglewood. And today, through the Spirit, I want to get into a lesson going into how you must be ordained by the Lord, okay? Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, to teach His Word, okay? And in that title alone, okay, is a lot of meat and a lot that can be extracted from that. Because you can't just pick up the Bible, okay, and go out and teach without having the understanding, okay? Because you got to remember, every idle word that you speak, you're going to have to be held accountable for. So if you're out here preaching the word with no knowledge, no wisdom, no understanding, ultimately, not the Rakakwadash, the Holy Spirit, you can be judged for that, okay? Especially when you're out there not using the true names of the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son, okay, and teaching the truth of the gospel, which is this word is for the people of Israel, all right? When I say the people of Israel, okay, a lot of you that are subscribed already know, but for those that don't, it's you so-called Negroes, you so-called Latinos, and you so-called Native Americans, okay? And of course, the speckled bird mingled amongst the other nations, okay, where our people have been scattered. Because we're going to come back in these last days calling upon the names of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai for strength, for forgiveness, ultimately in repentance, looking like these other nations and speaking their language, okay? And that's a stumbling block in of itself for a lot of our people that have so-called woken up to this truth, because you go by the outer appearance and not by the spirit, all right? Now, without further ado, we're just going to jump right into it. And remember, the lesson is called, you must be ordained by the Lord in order to teach His word, because this isn't of us. This is the word of the Heavenly Father, and He chooses who goes out to teach His word, okay? This isn't of us. We didn't decide that one day we're just going to wake up, we're going to get these precepts, and we're going to hit the highways and hedges. We got to be realistic. Before we woke up to this truth, we had other aspirations, other things that we wanted to do, all in vanity, of course, because what's more important than teaching the word of the Heavenly Father? Being chosen as a vessel for the purpose of the Creator, right? It doesn't get any higher than that. But in our own hubris, we thought that we wanted to be something in this world that's going to be destroyed, not knowing that the fame that the Heavenly Father is going to put on us for being obedient to His will is going to far exceed anything we could have gained on this side and any corruptible crown that we could have received, okay? Now, when you go into the word ordained, okay, the common definition, if you will, it says to make someone a priest or minister. That right there should let you know, okay, that to be ordained, you must be an Israelite. Because all the priests and ministers of Yahweh Bashem Shai in the scriptures were Israelites. Especially in the Old Testament, the priestly tribe was the Levitical tribe from the tribe of Levi. Okay? Now, that distinction has fell upon the rest of the tribes, but then that in of itself lets you know that it's still only talking about the nation of Israel, okay? It says, to make someone a priest or minister to confer holy orders on. So the holy orders, remember, to be holy means to be set apart, okay? And the only nation out of all creation that was set apart for the purpose of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai was the nation of Israel. Yasharallah, He prints power. The princes of the power. Who's that power? That power is Yahweh, the ultimate power. He surnamed a particular nation of people, 12 tribes, one nation, unto Himself. Okay? It says to order or decree something officially. Okay? So when you look at in this world, what you perceive to be right and wrong, it's all based on morality, And the ultimate morality goes back to the scripture. Yahweh Hashem Hashai has laws, statutes, and commandments that tell you how you should move, how you should live your life, okay? How to solve certain problems that come up. Yahweh Hashem Hashai already had that laid out in his laws, statutes, and commandments. And that was supposed to be taught and administered and ultimately kept by that same set apart people, the nation of Israel. And because we could not keep those laws, statutes, and commandments perfectly, okay, we fell upon the curses, all right? And our punishment for breaking that ultimate covenant is almost up, okay? That's the whole reason why our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai, came and died. He had to inhabit the same sinful flesh and kept those same laws, statutes, and commandments perfectly that we could not keep, and ultimately died that sacrificial lamb with the shedding of his blood, his innocent blood, to bring back his people to the good graces of the Heavenly Father. Because remember, Yahweh Shai was from the tribe of Judah. Alright? Now, I'm going to bring out some scriptures. We're going to begin in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 1, verse 4. It says, the calling of Jeremiah. Now, Jeremiah in the Hebrew, Yeremiah, means he exalts Yahweh. Okay? And ultimately, those called into this truth, speaking about the men first and foremost, the elect, the prophets, those whom are ordained to teach this word, are ultimately going to exalt their power and his only begotten son, Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Okay? So we can liken the story of Jeremiah unto the story of the elect. Alright? And you'll see what I mean once I begin breaking this down. This is Jeremiah 1 and 4. It says, the word of the Lord, Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, came unto me, saying, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee. And I ordained thee a prophet unto the nations. You got to remember, the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, is the Father of spirits. So before he sends that spirit down into its particular body, he knows the spirits. Okay? It doesn't matter what you look like on this side. It matters the spirit within you. And he knows those who are his. Before he formed us in our mother's womb, he knew us in the heavens. Okay? So he knows which men are his that are ordained to teach this word. And he has activated those same spirits here in these last days to bring his people back into the fold. Okay? And once that last number of the elect is sealed in, the destruction is going to come. And we are living in the midst of those days now, even as I speak. Okay? It says, then said I, ah, Lord power, behold, I cannot speak, for I am a child. So this is Jeremiah, who was a young man, okay, speaking in his carnal mind. Lord, you chose me, but I can't speak. I'm just a child. Okay? Who's going to listen to me? Is basically what he's saying. I have no authority, right? But if you were ordained to teach this word, you have all the authority in the world, because it is coming from on high. You got to remember, Yahweh Hashem Hashai rules in the kingdom of men. And even in the scriptures, wise men, okay, kings and rulers and governors oftentimes sought out the counsel of these such prophets, okay? It says, verse 7, but the Lord Yahweh Hashem Hashai said unto me, say not, I am a child, for thou shalt go to all that I shall send thee, and whatsoever I command thee, thou shalt speak. So that goes to show you that the words that come out of our mouth are ordained by the Spirit. Okay? Especially us doing this work in truth and sincerity. These are the words of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Alright? It says, be not afraid of their faces, for I am with thee to deliver thee, saith the Lord Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Then said the Lord Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, put forth his hand. But it says, then the Lord Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai put forth his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai said unto me, behold, I have put my words in thy mouth. Okay? So we don't have to worry about what we're going to say and be worried about how it comes across. It doesn't matter how old we are, old or young. Okay? As long as we are physically able to hit the highways and hedges, okay, we are required to spread this word. And it's the word of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Okay, remember, if they don't grasp onto the word, and when I say they, I mean our people, the true Israelites according to the Bible, that's because it wasn't meant for them to get it. But we still have a job to do, because the elect are going to hear, they're going to receive, they're going to repent, and they're going to come back into the fold. And this is the way Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai wants it done. As the scriptures say, by the foolishness of preaching. Okay? It says, see, I have this day set thee over the nations and over the kingdoms to root out and to pull down and to destroy and to throw down, to build and to plant. And that's the balance. And that's the power of this word. The word of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai is doing these very things. Look at Babylon the Great now, circling the drain. All because the words of the prophets are ringing true and bringing forth the prophecy that was written. Okay? Let's get John 15 and verse 16. This is the book of St. John, chapter 15, verse 16. And these are the words of Yahweh Shai. It says, ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that ye should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it to you. Okay? And these are the words of Yahweh Shai. Okay? The Heavenly Father, Yahweh, and His only begotten Son, Yahweh Shai, are on one accord. Okay? They are on one accord. They are in complete agreement. Alright? The word that we're teaching and we're preaching is Yahweh Shai. The scriptures say He comes in the volume of the book. And we declare the whole gospel. The good, the bad, the ugly. Alright? We are not ashamed of the gospel. You got to remember, this is our book. This is our history. Okay? These great men written about in these scriptures. Okay? This is a book of the Israelites. Alright? Let's get 1 Corinthians 1. Let's see. 1 Corinthians. Where am I at? No, let's see. Let's get 1 Corinthians 2, beginning at verse 7. Alright. It says, but we speak the wisdom of the Most High in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom which the Most High ordained before the world unto our glory. Okay? And then the whole point of this is, we speak the wisdom of the Most High in a mystery. Not everybody could get this. Alright? These secrets, these prophecies, these precepts, these breakdowns. That's why not anyone can just pick up these scriptures and go out and teach them in complete understanding. You still have pastors and priests today that say certain books of the scriptures, okay, are still unlocked and hidden, which is false. We have received the whole gospel. Okay? Amos 3 and 7. Let's get that. I was about to quote it. I can just pull it up real quick. Alright? One of my favorite scriptures. Amos 3 and 7. It says, surely the Lord, Yahweh Hashem Hashai, will do nothing, but He revealed His secret unto His servants, the prophets. Alright? And what did we just read? Okay? What did we just read? In 1 Corinthians 2 and 7, it says, but we speak the wisdom of the Most High in a mystery, even the hidden wisdom. But those secrets have been revealed to us. Okay? It's not a mystery to us. It makes perfect sense, and we see it in its full, true clarity. Alright? It says, which the Most High ordained before the world unto our glory. Okay? So before the world, He had already ordained the spirits that were going to come down with the complete understanding and preach this word. And Lord willing, we are those same men coming to fulfill our stead in these last days. Okay. Let's get Isaiah 51 and 16. Alright. This is the book of Isaiah 51 and 16, which reads, and I have put my words in thy mouth, and I have covered thee in the shadow of my hand, that I may plant the heavens and lay the foundation of the earth, and say unto Zion, thou art my people. So the point, Yahweh Hashem Hashai put his words in our mouth, okay? It says, and he has covered us with the shadow of his hand. Who is the right hand of the Heavenly Father? His only begotten Son, Yahweh Hashai. Okay? It says, that I may plant the heavens and lay the foundations of the earth and say unto Zion, thou art my people. Well, who is Zion? In the Hebrew, to Zion, which means a monument or memorial. His people, Israel. Okay? Zion. They are the people of the Lord. Israel are the people of the Lord. Those that were surnamed, okay, by Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Alright. Let's get Acts 8, verse 30. And we're about to close it out here. Just want to get a couple more points through the Spirit. Acts chapter 8, beginning at verse 30. Okay, and this is the account of Philip ministering unto the Ethiopian eunuch, which was an Israelite foreigner. Okay, so this is Acts 8, beginning of verse 30. It says, and Philip ran thither to him and heard him read the prophet Isaiah, and said, understand thou what thou readest? And he said, how can I, except some man should guide me? And he desired Philip that he would come up and sit with him. Okay? And that shows the humility, okay, of this Ethiopian eunuch. Because he recognized that though he had the zeal of the Most High, it wasn't according to knowledge. In a sense, that he believed, but he didn't understand completely what he was reading. And he had desired a man of the Lord to break it down to him in truth and sincerity. That is a man of character, a man of integrity. He could have easily said, of course I know what I'm reading. Go on about your business. But he said, no, how can I understand unless a man teach me? And the Spirit supped with him, and Philip broke down the scriptures to him. Okay? And that's exactly what we're doing when we go on the highways and hedges. When we put up video epistles like this. We're breaking down these scriptures through the Spirit and power of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. But the point is, it's the word of the Lord. It's not of us. Okay? That must be understood. We are coming in all humility, letting you know that these are the words of the Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. And if you don't agree with them, the problem is not with us. It's with the Heavenly Father. We are just the messengers. We are just the vessels used to bring this word out. All right? And I want to end this in Isaiah 30 and 20. Okay? Through the Spirit. That's exactly what the Ethiopian eunuch was reading, right? The book of Isaiah. So through the Spirit, we're going to end it in Isaiah chapter 30, verse 20. Okay? It says, and though the Lord give you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction, yet shall not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore, but thine eyes shall see thy teachers. Okay? So despite the different chastisements, the trials and tribulations we go through, the hell that we catch, the Most High has his men set up to bring that ultimate comfort, that ultimate good news, the gospel, that this is not the end-all, be-all of our people, that we have a kingdom awaiting, that our Savior is going to return, and we are going to be delivered and made righteous, okay? And that is a promise from Yahweh Hashem Hashai to his people, and we are in the midst of fulfilling that prophecy. The Lord willing, this lesson was edifying to the hopeful elect. I want to give all glory and honor to Yahweh, Hashem Yahweh Shai, Hashem Rakach Kodash. Double honor to the apostles and the elders, the great millstones who rule well, and peace and salutation to the hopeful elect who are continuing to fight and teach this thing of ours in truth and sincerity. Until the next lesson, Shalom.
fire.